Hey Canucks fans, the Canucks return home for a massive game tonight against the Calgary Flames. I'm Clay Emo, I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter, I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCPC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club, and this is my Canucks take, all in one take. It's Clay's Canucks commentary for Saturday, February the 8th. Canucks are back from their road trip, a five-gamer that saw them go 2-2-1, meaning they got 5 points out of a possible 10. And now it is time to come home and to start to rack up some more points. And they're playing against another Pacific Division rival, the Calgary Flames, who sit 5 points behind the Canucks in the standings with the same number of games played. So today, I want to preview tonight's game a little bit and talk about a couple other random stories, including Michael Ferland, Wayne Simmonds, Elias Pettersson, and Trevor Linden and the Sedins. So let's get to all that right now. Firstly, tonight's game. I'm actually recording this at 9 a.m., so an hour and a half before the Canucks have their game day skate. So no news on Pettersson, no news on any other lineup changes. Maybe Demko in for Markstrom, we'll see. But I probably won't do a video after the practice day, so you just have to follow Twitter to get those line combinations. But obviously, we hope that Pettersson comes in. The whole look of the team changes when you don't have your best player in there, and then everyone has to play up, a spot or two. And then we saw that the Canucks didn't have a lot of chemistry, didn't have a lot of flow in their game against Minnesota. Maybe that was because it was the end of a long road trip, but we'll see what happens tonight. Fantenberg's on the IR, so it's probably Jordy Benn comes in on the blue line. So that's a kind of a seamless switch there. Benn started the season before Fantenberg replaced him. But up front, we'll see what happens. We'll see if Justin Bailey gets a look. We'll see if McEwen stays in. We'll see if Pettersson is good to go. So a lot of questions up front that we'll probably have some answers in about an hour and a half. Now, playing against Calgary, proverbial four-point game once again, division rival. And what's really interesting is, despite the Canucks' three-game losing streak now, they haven't lost any ground in the standings. There's no teams making up ground, because the last couple times that the Canucks have lost, three out of the other four teams that are chasing the Canucks have also lost. The Canucks have been atop the Pacific Division now for 3 weeks. On Saturday, January the 18th, they took over the Pacific Division lead with that home win against San Jose. I think it was 4-1. That was the Lunar New Year game that I was at. And that was exactly 3 weeks ago today. And at that time, you might remember, Vancouver had 58 points, and the other four teams, Calgary, Edmonton, Vegas, and Arizona, all had 57 points. Well, in 3 weeks, despite the Canucks' three straight losses, they've actually expanded that lead. So now Vancouver is sitting with 65 points, two up on Vegas with 63, three up on Edmonton with 62, four up on Arizona with 61, and five up on Calgary with 60. So that means, yes, the Canucks have moved 7 points in the past 3 weeks, right, with three wins and a shootout loss. So they've gone kind of 3-1-3, I guess, or 3-1-2, I guess, in those six games in the last 3 weeks. Don't forget, there's an all-star break in there as well. But the other teams have barely moved, and they've actually moved less than the Canucks have moved. So you have Arizona that's moved 6 points, Edmonton that's moved 5 points, Vegas that's moved 6 points, Edmonton that's moved five, Arizona moved four, and Calgary's only moved 3 points in the past 3 weeks. So that's not gonna get done, 1 point a week. And granted, yes, all these teams had their mandated week-long break, but they all had them, whether it was the first week or the second week. So everyone's had their break. So there's no more big breaks coming up. So Vancouver's actually expanded their lead. They've opened a 5 point cushion over Calgary, where 3 weeks ago it was only 1 point. So I that's a good glass half full. That's a positive way of looking at it, that the Canucks, despite losing the last three, are still atop the Pacific Division. And they have a chance tonight to put that road trip behind them, a road trip that started off so well, ended poorly, but they have a chance to put that behind them with a solid effort against Calgary tonight. And then it's the start of an extended homestand that includes Sedin week, which I'll get to in a second. So that's tonight, Calgary in Vancouver. Should be a really good game. We'll see if Calgary's been a little beat up with their two battles with Edmonton in the past few weeks. Of course, no Mark Giordano tonight, although the injury news for him wasn't nearly as bad as they first feared. So we'll see what happens tonight. And it's Vancouver and Calgary, which is a nice segue into Michael Ferland, and then by extension, Wayne Simmonds. Michael Ferland, when he came here, I was excited, and you guys might remember from my vlogs from the summer, out of all of our free agent guys, so not JT Miller because he was a trade, but of all the free agent guys, Myers, Ben, Fantenberg, I was most excited about Michael Ferland, not just because he was a forward, but because I remember how much he ran roughshod when he was playing for Calgary against the Vancouver Canucks in that 2015 playoff series. Again, the last time the Canucks were in the playoffs, five seasons ago now. So I remember how good he was, how dominant he was. And he's had a really disappointing first year, obviously only playing 14 games for the Canucks, finishing only 12 of them because he left two of them because of injury. So he and Josh Levo, who's coming back from injury in the next, hopefully, month or month and a half, you could argue those two guys are almost like free agent or trade acquisition from a standpoint of they're not with the team right now. They haven't been for the past little bit, last month or so. And then you're inserting two, maybe not top six, but at least two top nine forwards into the lineup. Two heavier guys, especially Ferlin, guys that can be intimidating, guys that you'll need for a deep playoff run. So that's, you know, kind of a nice way of looking at it, saying the Canucks don't have to do much. They don't have to trade away much because they have Ferlin, of course, all depending on his health, and Josh Levo, hopefully as well, returning. And that's two top nine forwards, which good. It makes our roster decisions tougher, which is what you want going into the postseason. But then there's all these rumors about Wayne Simmonds coming over from, trading for him from New Jersey. And we've, Pierre LeBrun started it, I think, on Thursday night and it's picked up a lot of steam in the Vancouver market over the past 48 hours. Now, Wayne Simmonds used to be a good player. He had two 60-point seasons when he was playing with Philly just 5 or 6 years ago. Also, I think there's a 55-point season in there. So he's pretty good. Like, he was pretty good. But in the last few seasons, last year, he only had 30 points combined in 79 games, I think, between Nashville before he got traded in New Jersey. And then this year, I think he only has 15 points or so in 59 games, if that makes sense. 15 to 19 points. I think it's only 15 points. I forgot to look it up, but I know it's not that much, basically. And yes, I do understand he plays on a bad New Jersey team, but I've heard that he still provides a lot of good leadership on that young New Jersey team. I like Wayne Simmonds as a player, as a person, for sure. I just don't think he's an upgrade over Michael Ferlin or Josh Levo at this point in Wayne Simmonds' career. Now, if you get him for something cheap, like a late-round draft pick because he's going to be a UFA, as long as you're not giving away a good prospect or even a decent roster player, you know, I'd entertain it. But I don't think they need to go there. There's other options that you can go to, including the two guys that we have on our own roster. So I hope the Canucks don't spend too much. If they do end up going after him, they don't have to. We'll see what happens. You know, there's rumors that just because LeBrun put out there doesn't mean it's true for sure. I'm sure there's an element to truth to it, but what we don't know is how interested the Canucks are, how interested Jim Benning is, and how much he'd be willing to spend. I think I can speak for all Canucks fans when we hope that the answer is not that much interest and he doesn't want to spend that much. So we'll have to track that over the next 2 weeks before the trade deadline on February 24th, but that'll be a very interesting story to watch. We need Michael Ferlin to come back, get some games in Utica, and then get up to our main roster and get at least a week of games in and see how good he is leading up to the trade deadline. So that's something very interesting to watch. Last thing I want to end off, we're coming into Sedins week. As they have the Legends Night on Monday night, where three of the four legends, the three four guys whose names are already up in the rafters, that would be Linden, Smeal, and Nazan will all be there. Sounds like Bure will not be there, which is fine. And then Wednesday night, it's the big actual jersey retirement game against Chicago. So I'm going to the Monday night game against Nashville. I'm going to the Wednesday night game against Chicago. So if you're there, make sure we say hello, take a picture or two, and then make a video, whatever it is. We'd love to celebrate the Sedins with anyone who's there. And then I'm not going to the Sunday game when they host Anaheim, when they celebrate the Sedins community work. So again, Legends Night on Monday night, actual retirement Wednesday night, jersey retirement, and then community focus appreciation on Sunday night. So I'm going to two of those three games, the Monday and the Wednesday. But so throughout this week, I'll be finding some old clips and old tweets and old videos of the Sedins and my experience with the Sedins, whether it would be a song I wrote about them or fist bumping them in the tunnel before their last home game. That was really cool. I'm going to share that footage again. Or a couple funny stories about my interactions with them, whatever it may be, I'll be sharing that throughout the week as we celebrate Sedin week. So I hope that you will see that. And I hope you saw the video that the Canucks released, the Budweiser ad, the 2.5 minute ad with guys like Bo Horvat, Nylander's in there, Stan Smeal's in there, a couple other, Jacob Markstrom's in there, and then some Canucks players, some Canucks staff. Really, really great video of the Sedins and their impact on our team and our city and our community. And a tearjerker for sure. So make sure you check out that video if you haven't seen it. Just go to the Canucks Twitter account and make sure you see that Budweiser commercial. Basically raising, this one's for you, 22 and 33. So a lot of cool things that are going to happen this week. And one of them that's getting a lot of news is Trevor Linden coming back. He has not really been here around since he was dismissed in June or July of 2018, just 3 months after the Sedins retired. And Ed Willis had a really good article with him, interview with him in The Province. And Linden said more by what he didn't say. Willis pressed him, you know, would you come back? You know, what are your feelings coming back? And would you come back for any other player? And does this mean the start of a hopefully some healing between him and the ownership, i.e. Aquilini? And Linden basically was very, all he wanted to do was talk about the Sedins. All he said was, I'm happy to be back for Henrik and Daniel. No mention of ownership, no mention of management, no mention of even other players. All he talked about was Henrik and Daniel and their impact on the game and his impressions of working with them and playing with them and trying to help lead them when he came back, when Linden came back for a second stint. So, like I said, he said more by what he didn't say. That refusing to answer any questions, refusing to take the bait. And I think this is going to be a kind of low-key major story this week, especially on Monday when we, after we get through tonight's game, where it's the build-up to Monday night's game where Linden will be there. Of course, he's going to get cheered. Of course, you know, there's going to be a lot of questions that demands on Linden's time for a comment. And I see him taking the high road. That's kind of what he's done, right? I see him taking the high road the entire time. So it's going to make for interesting drama. I don't know how exciting it's going to be, but it's certainly intriguing for sure. And it'll be very fascinating to see how that plays out as well. So Canucks fans, three or four little random or tidbits to talk about today. What's your feelings for tonight's game against Calgary? Are you surprised that the Canucks are still atop their division despite losing three straight? What do you think of this? These rumors about Wayne Simmonds coming? And what do you think of this perceived rift that seems to be more perceived between Linden and Aquilini? And do you think it'll cast a shadow at all over this week's activities and festivities celebrating the Sedins? So many things to talk about. Leave a comment below. Talk about any of those things or whatever you want to talk about. I love to read, react, and reply as always. I'm not going to tonight's game. Sold my tickets. I'll be watching at home while babysitting my lovely niece, Audrey. But I'll be watching the game from home, probably checking in with a couple intermission reflections and then again a post-game vlog as well. Looking forward to watching it from the comforts of my own home tonight before I'm in the arena Monday and Wednesday. So Canucks fans, score prediction, who's going to win, anything like that for tonight. Talk about the Sedins week. Talk about Trevor Linden. Talk about Michael Ferland. Talk about Wayne Simmonds, Elias Pettersson. Whatever you want, you type it down there. And I will happily read, react, and reply. And there we go. Lots to talk about today. Subscribe if you like to. Like this video if you like to. Enjoy the day. God bless. Enjoy the game. And go Canucks go.